Hello children, welcome back to the biology class. Hope you are all fine and safe and enjoying at home, having good tasty food prepared by mommy or granny. Yes, and you are with good health because of the climatic condition. Let God bless you with good health and strength. Okay children, see, we have done with two chapters. Okay, and in this class we are going to continue with the third chapter, that is about the conservation of plants and animals. Okay, if you take plant, biologically we tell it as flora, and animals are the fauna. It's very simple in scientific language, protecting the fauna and flora. Okay, see, because of the increase in the population, whatever it's going on around our world, what happened? The greeneries are being destroyed. Okay, we cut the trees. Practically speaking, we destroy the forest and we are converting that into the layouts. Okay, or the buildings. And we use those woods, whichever present on the trees, we use them either to prepare the paper or to prepare the furniture. Okay, so in this lesson, we are going to discuss about how we are going to conserve, means protect, these plants and animals. Okay, not only plants, we have to protect the animals. Okay, like when we were like you, when I'm like you, in my place like in Ooty, we used to see so many varieties of monkeys. Okay, sparrows, myna, pigeon. You know, if we put rice to get dry in the sun, like all the birds variety will come and eat and go. Okay, but if I go now, so hard to find the birds in my place. Okay, the number of living beings like these are decreasing because of us. Okay, we have to conserve them. We have to protect them. Okay, and I remember telling in the last class, only few children were there, you know, there were like so many varieties of fruits which was eaten by us. Just check with your mummy and daddy. There was some fruit called as vikkipalam. There was some fruit called as thautupalam. Okay, they all like, you know, it was grown in Ooty, and you know, like nowadays they are telling the skalpadi, arapadi and all, no, when we go to buy the flowers. Okay, in that they used to measure and give for 25 paise, 50 paise and 1 rupee. Okay, and it will be so yummy. The taste will be so good. And if you break the seed of that vikkipalam and eat, it will be like, you know, our days, like nowadays, walnut. We used to have even walnut. There are trees of walnut near my college. It was there. Somewhere in, you know, late 90s and early 2000, we were doing it. We were eating it. Okay, and now, if I go near my college, everything is being destroyed. All the trees were cut off. And there is a house in that area. Okay, so we have to conserve these varieties of plants and varieties of animals so that our future generation, see, like story I'm telling you, it should not be the same to your children. Okay, when the days pass by, it should be there again so that practically you can show it. Okay, and there was a fruit, you know, with a loose jacket around it. Okay, it will be like, you know, what is that? Star fruit. It will be just like star fruit, the covering. And in the center, it will be like some yellow color fruit. We never bother to eat it. We just ignore it. Okay, and that fruit nowadays, it's 3,000 rupees in the market. Okay, there is some fruit called as tree tomato. Okay, I'm telling only about Ooty. I don't know about plains because we migrated to the plains just 3-4 years back. Okay, when we were in the hills, like, you know, these are these varieties of fruits which we used to eat free of cost, passion fruit. Okay, free of cost, we just go pluck it from the plant and we eat. Okay, there were no chemicals. Okay, and there were no fertilizers or manures or something like that. It was very pure. Okay, and now it has become costlier because of our lifestyle. Okay, see children, and let me proceed with the lesson. Okay, in this lesson, we are going to learn about the wildlife sanctuary. Okay, about the national park, about the biosphere reserve. Okay, what is wildlife sanctuary, national park and biosphere reserves? Are very simple, preserving the living being, either plant or animal, to our future generation, conserving it, protecting it. Okay, there is on the way to Ooty, you can find Mundandurai forest, and you can find Mudumalai forest. There you can find the ample number of wildlife. Okay, why they have built the national sanctuaries means to protect the wildlife. Okay, there are so many varieties of deer. Okay, I remember my daughter screaming looking at the deer like a variety of sheep. She said, "Pulli aadu odudhu." Okay, because she doesn't know, since she was here in hill station. Okay, it is a variety of deer which will be running very fastly in the forest. Okay, so bringing them out, growing them out in the protected area are nothing but the wildlife sanctuary or the national park. Okay, and biosphere reserve. Okay, next one. What is meant by biodiversity? We are going to learn that is a variety of living organism in a specific area. Okay, if we take, for example, if we take our own, our Dimbam route, no? That is the way from Satyamangalam to Mysore till Chamrajpet, you'll be finding a variety of living organism. Preserving them is called as, the number of microorganism over there, it's called as biodiversity, and preserving them, it's called as biosphere reserve. Okay, there was years back when I went to Mysore, when I went to Coorg on the way to Mysore, okay, we found a variety of monkey called as lion-tailed macaque. Okay, the tail will be just like lion, and they'll be having fur around their face. On looking at it, like, it will be so beautiful. You know, just when you're going to the hill station, enjoy the nature. Okay, you feel that those monkeys smiling at you. They'll be so happy. Okay, it was there. And now, recently when we went to Coorg last year, I was not able to find, the number got decreased. Okay, so the number of wild animals and the wild plants in a particular area, it is nothing but the biodiversity. Okay, and plants, as I already said, plants of the area, it's called as flora, and the animals are called as fauna. Okay, it may be a chainy area, maybe a palm tree in your area, it is called as flora, and the dog in your area, it's called as fauna. That's all. Okay, and endemic species means certain varieties of animals which is seen only in that particular area. Okay, if you take dahlia, there are so many varieties of dahlia seen in Ooty. Okay, so it is an endemic species. That variety of plant, it is seen only in that area, it's called as endemic species. Okay, fig. Variety of fig are available in Erkad. So that is the endemic species of Erkad. Okay. And then, a data or a detail or a record about the living organism in that particular area, it is maintained in a book called as Red Data Book. Okay. And if the animals, they move from one place to another place, they are called as, it is called as migration. Okay, every year, if you see the birds, if you go to Vedanthangal, there is a place near Chennai. If you go there, on the winter season, you will find millions of birds coming from foreign country to our country. Okay, and then because it will be very, the temperature will be very less in the foreign countries during the winter season. Okay, since it will be a little bit warmer, they'll come here. And once the climate gets all right, when it comes to the, you know, after winter, when it moves to the spring, they'll get back to their own places. These are called as migration. There is a variety of eelfish. Okay, for spawning, that is for, reproducing, they'll move from river to sea. Once the reproduction is over, they'll get back to their place. These things are called as migration. Okay, and what we have to do, it is our responsibility as the citizen of this country, it is you and me, we should take care of the reserve. Okay, that is the biosphere reserve, we should take care, we should protect, we should try protecting the animals by animals and plants by either reforestation or, you know, taming the animals at home. Okay, and we can try recycling and reusing the papers so that the cutting down of trees can be reduced. Okay, and we are going to read something about reforestation, that is planting the trees. That's what we are doing now. We are back into the greenery. Okay, in every house we can find at least two trees. Okay, like long back, maybe our foreparents have committed the mistake by cutting the trees, and now at this generation we are planting the trees and we are trying to maintain the greenery, which is nothing but the reforestation. Deforestation means destroying the trees. Afforestation means again planting the trees. Reforestation means bringing them to their original state, is called as reforestation. Is that clear, children? About all this we are going to learn in this lesson. Okay, yeah, bye.